Hi friends, Lauren of The Simplest Self here. Today we're going to work through about a 15-minute upper body shoulders yin practice. You will not need any props today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, turn on the notifications so you don't miss any new videos. And if you want to see more yoga and personal life from me, you can follow me on Instagram at The Simplest Self. I hope you enjoy this practice and I will see you on the mat. Friends, we're going to start on our bellies today, actually. So just make your way down, belly to the mat. You're going to bring your arms along your sides and let your left ear rest to the earth. And let the eyes fall closed. Notice the heaviness of the front body with your next few exhalations. So you're noticing fronts of the shoulders, belly, maybe the low back. Noticing the thighs, the shins, and whatever part of the tops of your feet are making connection with the earth or your mat. Softening the jaw. Take another breath here. And switching sides, just bringing the right ear to the mat. Noticing the differences in the sides of the shoulders. Noticing the differences in the sides of the neck. Oftentimes at the beginning of the practice, you'll notice the mind still might be fluttering around. That's okay. And instead of trying to push the thoughts away, instead also notice sensation of body and the deep breaths that you're currently taking in your body. One more breath. And so for our first pose today, we're going to stand our bellies getting into the front of the chest and a bit of the deltoid. So just lift your upper back and head for a moment and come on your forearms. So you're on your forearms, there's a little bit of chest extension right now. Keep the glutes really soft, the belly really soft. Two options for this. So first option is to reach your right arm out to the side. Arm is relatively, or the shoulder and the elbow are relatively in the same line. You don't want the elbow to come up really far. And then from here, take your left hand, form a 90 degree angle with your left arm. You're just going to press yourself over on your right side. So you're coming onto your outer right hip. Maybe the ear rests to the earth. This is option one. If you feel like you still have a bit more space, I want you to come out of it for a moment and then bend your right elbow. So your right elbow forms a 90 degree angle against the earth. This is going to get more into the deltoid. So then further, press onto the right side, let the right ear rest, or it could hover to a block, or it could just hover in space. So you're here, maybe you stay, or if you'd like, you can take your left leg, lift it, bend the left leg, and step it over the right. This is quite a bit of extension in the low back, so just be really mindful what this feels like in your body. At this point, I like to walk the left hand closer in towards the chest, or maybe even just rest the left forearm to the earth, just really, really loosey-goosey. And final thing, there's a tendency for the chin to jut forward, so just try to lengthen the neck, press the chin back a little bit. You know, about maybe 45 seconds here, just in your own body. Notice the full capacity of your next inhale. One more breath, take a big inhale. And just part the lips, let it go, exhale. Left leg stacks, come back over. Just for a moment, arms along the sides, left ear rests to the earth, fronts of the shoulders heavy. Take a deep breath. Lift the chest and the head, come back onto the forearms. Let's do the other side. So either left arm reaches out to the side, pressing your right hand into the mat, coming over to your left side. Or you could bend the left elbow if there's just a bit more range of motion in the shoulder girdle today. So coming onto the left side, you'll notice again the chin wants to come in towards the chest a bit. So try to lift the front of the throat away from the chest. Option to stay or bend the right knee, step the foot behind. And then maybe again, the right fingertips can rock closer in. You could literally just rest the forearm, what feels good for you. Letting the dust settle. Noticing where you feel this most right now. Unclenching the teeth. About 40 more seconds just in your own body. Try to bring just a bit more length to your next two exhalations. Final breath. Right leg stacks, come back onto your belly, arms along the sides. Just for a moment, rest the right ear, maybe an open mouth exhalation. Then from here, lift the head, lift the chest, coming into embryo pose. So bring the hands underneath the shoulders, elbows hug in, tuck the toes. Just press onto a tabletop, so coming onto all fours. Bring the knees and the thighs close to one another, untuck the toes. And then arms alongside the body, rest the forehead down or again to a block. There is a generous fold in the fronts of your thighs right now. And try to release in the fronts of the shoulders. And it's like the forehead is really melting towards the earth right now. Simultaneously, your back body is expanding with the inhales. So back body expansion, take a big inhale. Front body heaviness with the exhale. Another few moments exactly as you are. Just giving yourself this break. Two more breaths. Deepest breath as you are, take an inhale. Just part your lips, let it go, exhale. Press back up. And then come back onto all fours. Take your all fours more towards the back of your mat so you have space out in front of you. Thread the needle pose to start out with. So keep your right hand as it is. Just weave your left arm underneath the right so the left ear rests to the mat. Instead of keeping your right hand as it is, step it a bit further out in front of you. There's still a bend in the elbow. And you'll notice as you take this, you can almost grip your right finger pads to the earth. And it's like you're trying to turn a bit more towards the center of the upper back. I like to close my eyes though, and if that feels safe for you, you can do so as well. So you're not jutting your gaze towards the ceiling. Awareness to how the inner left shoulder blade is almost sliding away from the spine. Check in with the jaw, check in with the left side of the head. And allow the next exhale to go through the mouth. Right hand walks a bit closer in, press back up into a tabletop. Then we're just going to switch sides. So left hand stays as is. Exhale, right arm weaves under. Right ear rests to the mat. Take your left hand, walk it a bit further forward, still a bend in the elbow, just so you can press a little bit into the left hand, spinning yourself a tiny bit more towards the upper back, the middle of the upper back, excuse me. As always though, if there is something that feels better in your body, you have full authority to make your way into that. True mindfulness is being aware of the sensations of the body and how can you trace that sensation and follow that sensation without judgment. So notice what your body needs in this moment. Notice if there's any places that you can release into. And be here right now. Just a few more moments. One more breath. Left hand walks in, come back to a tabletop. Just for a second, a round of cat and cow, find an inhale, let the belly drape down, reach the heart forward. And then exhale to round your spine, draw the chin in. Just pause here with this rounded upper back. Press the hips from right to left for a second. So noticing the low back, noticing QL. You want to pick up the fingertips a little bit as you do this. Sometimes that feels good as well. About two more breaths here. One more moment. Come back to center. Just for a second. Again, the knees further back. Puppy pose. So take your arms a wide space out in front of you. Hands can be flat or you can spider the fingers. And then with an exhale, just let the forehead reach to the earth. I almost prefer spider fingers sometimes because there's a bit more engagement of the arms. Pressing the finger pads down, the shoulders are not completely coming out of their sockets. There's a gentle pressing of the finger pads down and back. Just about 30 seconds here. Notice the rib cage. Notice the sides of the underarms. One more breath. Lift the head, lift the chest. Come into a seat. You can sit crisscross, you can rest on your heels, whatever feels best for you. Just ending with about 30 seconds each side with eagle arms. So bring your right arm on top of the left eagle arms. If this doesn't feel okay for you, you can just reach your right arm out to the side. Left hand rests around the, that's your right forearm. So you choose right arm on top or right arm reaches across. Squeeze the forearm, squeeze the wrists, draw the back of the skull up and back. If you'd like, close the eyes. Maybe you want to turn the head a little bit. Maybe you like to stay in stillness. Also, you could incorporate a forward fold. One more breath. And then just switching sides. So left arm on top of the right. Again, give the forearms a little bit of a squeeze. Give the wrists a bit of a squeeze. Option to extend the left arm across the body if eagle arms just doesn't feel right today. Notice the back of the skull. So lift it up and away. Notice the rib cage. Draw it in a little bit. And notice the pelvis. It's heavy towards the sits bones or the earth. With just about 30 seconds here, if you want to turn the head or take a fold, all of those are options. Feel this feeling of being in your body. One more breath. Let that go. Hands, palms face down on the thighs. I invite you to close your eyes. If you'd like, you can bring hands to prayer, thumbs to the center of the chest, gaze shifts down, or option to a hand to belly and a hand to the center of the chest. Let's take a final breath together. Take an inhale. Part the lips, exhale. Have a beautiful rest of your day and week. Namaste.